हेलो क्लास सिक्स स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी कैन स्टार्ट हिस्ट्री पोर्शन लेसन नंबर 1। और लेसन नेम इज एन अप्रोच टूवर्ड्स द पास्ट। नॉलेज दैट इज गेन्ड फ्रॉम द स्टडी ऑफ पास्ट इज कॉल्ड हिस्ट्री। इट टीचेज अस ग्रेट लेसन्स, इट गाइड्स अस व्हाट टू डू एंड व्हाट नॉट टू डू। History also informs us about our rich past, how people lived, what they ate, what they wore, and what types of houses they built. We know that the present cannot be understood without understanding our past. The people who describe the past are known as historians. Importance of history. The study of history is an important in many ways. We come to know about the kingdoms, dynasties, kings and leaders by studying history. It also deals with the lives and activities of ordinary people who have shaped the pages of history. The knowledge gained from the study of history is important to understand both the past and the present. Whatever is happening today will be history tomorrow. Each one of us is adding something big or small to our history, our family's history, and our country's history. History guides people to set goals and tells them not to make the same mistakes. We understand the continuous development of human beings by studying history. It includes the study of literature, religion, art, and architecture. We can easily understand the basic nature of our society by studying history. We study why people behaved the way they did, how and why they fought or cooperated or built forest. Division of past. The past has been divided by historians into two periods, prehistory and history. Prehistory. It is the period of human development when writing had not been invented and human beings did not know how to read and write. Hence, there are no written records for this period. We can know prehistory only throughout archaeology. To understand prehistory, archaeologists dig deep into the ground and collect remains of the past. These are archaeological remains like tools, coins, bones, pots and jewelry help us to know about the past. History. It is the period for which written records are available. This covers the time period after the invention of writing. Early writing was done on the barks of birch trees, clay tablets, palm leaves, copper plates, and rock pillars. Sources of history. The difficult question now is how we can know about something that took place thousands of years ago. A very simple answer to this difficult question is that we learn about the past from the remains which people of that period have left behind. By studying these remains, archaeologists and historians tell us what might have happened in the past. Sources of history are divided into two broad groups: archaeological sources, literary sources. Archaeological sources are direct evidences they have a significant effect on the writing of history. They cannot be changed or altered by human beings. They are physical evidences that are available. Artifacts, the objects of different kinds made by humans in the past, are called artifacts. For example, things like metal objects, pottery, tools, ornaments, jewelry, weapons, and sculptures. They gave us important clues and help us in understanding the cultural life of the past. The objects found at Harappa and Mohenjo-daro threw light on the development aspects of that age. Harappa and Mohenjo-daro are 4,000 years old cities along the banks of River Indus. Monuments, old buildings, ruins of old buildings, temples, stupas, mosques, tombs, caves, palaces, and old settlements, which are historically important and provide important information of our past heritage, are called monuments. You can see in this picture a stupa, an archaeological source. The archaeological excavations at Harappa and Mohenjo-daro quote Dizi, Roper, Mehrgarh, and several other sites have proved that a planned civilization existed in the Indus Valley 5,000 years ago. The ruins of Nalanda in Bihar reveals the ancient system of education. Coins are valuable sources of information. These coins are made of gold, silver, copper, and other metals. You can see Indian coins, Panchmark coins, Mohur of Akbar, Indo-Greek coins. They tell us about the economy of the kingdom. The periods of rulers had trade activities with other regions. Inscriptions are written, records engraved on rocks, metal pillars, copper plates, caves walls, walls of temples and palaces, and on clay tablets. Inscriptions provides us important information about events, ruling, and declaration of ancient rulers. Inscriptions also deal with the administration and the personal qualities of the kings. They also provide us with important dates of coronation, specimen of art, and relation with neighborings and distant rulers. Literary sources, whatever our ancestors wrote in an evidence in the form of written records, these are literary sources. In the beginning, when paper was not invented, people of that period used to write on bhojpatras, the dried bark of trees. They also wrote on solid rock stones, copper plates, rock pillars, and tablets. It is from these records our history is made. As we know it today, handwritten records of the past in the form of books are called manuscripts. These accounts of contemporary events help us in knowing our past and provide us information about customs, religious beliefs, and cultures of people. Literary sources may be divided into two types: religious literature, writing that details with religion is called religious literature. The Vedas, the Aranyakas, the Brahmanas, the Upanishads, the Triptakas, Dipvamsas, Mahavishma and Jataka are old religious books of the subcontinent. These give us important information about ancient India. Secular literature, writing which are not religious are known as secular literature. These include the historical accounts and biographies written by poets and foreign travelers. They were written to record happenings, events, administrative setup, rules and declaration by the kings. The Arthashastra written by Kautilya on how to run the government gives us information about the Mauryan administration and contemporary society. Travelers' accounts are also included in secular literature. A number of foreign travelers who visited India from time to time left very important social and political accounts of the country in their travelogues. Megasthenes lived in India for some time as the Greek ambassador at the court of Chandragupta Maurya. He wrote the Indica. Geographical impacts. The geography of the country plays a major role in its history. Similarly, the geographical features of India have greatly influenced its people and their history. Even the name of the country, India, has its origin in its geography. The Indians and Greeks called river Indus as Indos or Indos, and so the land to the east of river was called India. The physical features of India that have shaped Indian history are, you can see in this map, physical map of the Indian subcontinent, many rivers are there. The Great Himalayas. The Himalayas in the north of India are very high, so they work as a natural barrier for invaders from the north. Hence, very few inventions have taken place from this side. In map, you can see this portion is Himalayas. Low-lying passes such as the Khyber, Tirchi, the Kunnun, the Gomal and the Bolan in the northwest were comparatively easy passes for the invaders to enter India. The northern plains, this is the northern plains. The northern plains have determined the development of India. The places along the rivers have developed faster than any other part of the country. Rivers were the main mode of travel. They provided the important sources of water and made the areas around them highly fertile. As a result, agriculture became prosperous near the banks of rivers, and even trade could easily flourish near the rivers. Some important rivers of North India are Bias, Ganga, Brahmaputra and Indus. The Deccan Plateau, down below portion is called Deccan Plateau. The Deccan had always been a very strong and powerful military base. So it was not easy for mighty powers of the north to win and control Deccan for a long time. Coastal plains towards western side and towards eastern side. The coastal plains of India were isolated by land they were open to the sea to establish commercial relations with the Europeans, South East Asian and African countries. Interestingly, the first Muslim and the Christian traders reached Kerala by the sea route. They reached in Kerala state. The concept of the dates in history. As we all know, we calculate our days and nights through a proper system of dates and years. We take the year of birth of the deceased Christ as zero. At zero, the left side of the given timeline, that is on next page, represent the years before Christ was born, and it is called BCE, before common era. For example, 50 years before Christ is written as 50 BCE. All dates before the birth of Christ are counted backwards. For example, 300 BCC will come first and 400 BCC will come later. On the other hand, anything that happened in the years after the birth of Jesus Christ are expressed in CE, that is common era. This is called common era because most countries of the world now use this. Earlier historians were using the terms BC for BCE and AD for CE. Now they use the terms BCE and CE. CE stands for common era and BCE stands for before common era. Now you can see timeline. Here this is, you can say, birth of Jesus Christ, and from here this side it is BC and this side it is CE up to here, present day. Cities began to develop in the Indian subcontinent around 2500 years BCE. It was also during this time that human settlements emerged in the Nile Valley in Egypt, as inscribed stone was found in Rosta, a town of the north coast of Egypt, that contained inscriptions in three different languages and scripts, one Greek and two Egyptian. Now we can see some important points based on lesson. Knowledge that is gained from the study of past is called history. Prehistory is the period of human development when writing had not been invented and human beings did not know how to read and write. History is the period for which written records are available. Sources of history are derived into archaeological sources and literary sources. Literary sources are divided into religious literature and secular literature. The geography of a country plays a vital role in its history. BCE, before common era, stands for anything that happened before the birth of Jesus Christ, and CE, common era, stands for anything that happened after the birth of Jesus Christ.